And blessings. This is Lisa Marie Goodson of the Afrocentric Home Decor Channel. And y'all, I told you before that I wanted to do something really big. And also for those that may be watching me from the Blackberry Beauty Academy, I wanted to do something that represented the community. But of course, for the Afrocentric Channel, I want to do something that represents our Afrocentricity. So today we are on the beautiful Main Street in Durham, North Carolina. Do you know that there was some time ago that this was known as the Black Wall Street? So we're actually the Black Wall Street of North Carolina. We are actually on the street where the history has taken place. And history is still actually taking place because today we are at the beautiful African and Afrocentric boutique called Ngozi. And so they have brought many blessings to our lives, my husband and I. I want to introduce you to the proprietors, the owner of this beautiful establishment. I want to show you around to their beautiful necklaces, jewelry, clothing, bags, accessories, books, art, everything. It's a beautiful collective, and they'll tell you more about it. I want you to meet our friends. Their name is Leon and Andrea Carter, and they've been here for only a couple of years, and they won the best of a new business or boutique, or they'll tell you in the neighborhood, in the Durham area. And so actually it's right here. It's the winner of the best of Durham. I mean, you can't say it easier than that. And so we're excited. 2017, we're excited to know them, to love them, and to meet them. And y'all, when y'all go in here, I just want y'all to get ready. We have masks, we have everything. You're going to want it. I'll tell you how to get in touch with them, how to buy more of it. Meanwhile, y'all, did y'all check out the dress here? Did you check out the dress? Say yes to the dress. But I want to show you some of their dresses, and hopefully I'll be modeling one of theirs soon. So come on in and let's be a part of this beautiful journey called Ngozi, where we bring you blessings.
Hi.
Peace and blessings. This is Lisa Marie Goodson of the Afrocentric Home Decor Channel. And for those that are watching me on my Blackberry Beauty Academy, I want to say welcome. And in the words of the spirit of Africa and African beautiful Afrocentric lifestyle, I want to use the word of this beautiful establishment. The name of this establishment is called Ngozi. Igbo. And you know what? That's important because I know you're Nigerians. I know the Igbo and the Yoruba don't like that. So it's Igbo and it means blessings. And so, yeah, so thank you for that. And so we're going to actually talk to the folks that own this beautiful space, and I want to ask them some questions about what was their inspiration, how did they get started, what is their background. As many of you know, I do my best to bring you quality products and services that our people would actually love to have. And so these two people, I mean, we came here, let's tell you a little backstory. My husband and I, we've only been in North Carolina for 7 months, and we walked into the shop next door. An assistant there told us that we needed to come over here and meet these two wonderful, beautiful people. And really, the rest is history. We've been friends ever since. We do consider them really good friends, and we are so happy to be here. So I'm honored. We're going to get a chance to look around and see the products and services. I bought a lot of stuff here. Y'all, I'm about to buy a lot more, so wait and see. And so without further ado, I want to introduce you to the Carter. So this is Leon and Andrea Carter, or Andrea and Leon Carter, because he was giving it up to the queen, and I really appreciate that.
Okay.
So, yes, y'all, so tell us a little bit about, first of all, I want you to introduce yourselves. Tell me a little bit about how long you've been in North Carolina, and just right into it, what was the inspiration for this space? Was it something you thought of for a long time? Was it? I would love to know the backstory to this.
Well, we're originally from New York.
Mm-hmm,
we
New
worked
York.
In corporate.
Yes.
Yeah, New York. I worked in publishing and advertising. She worked in the fashion industry for about a good 35 years.
Wow.
And we had decided to, well, during the last Great Recession, things kind of changed around and found ourselves in Atlanta for about a good year.
Mm-hmm.
And then we wound up here in Durham. So, and Andrea has always been interested in making jewelry, and she knows how to sew.
Mm-hmm.
And so we said, you know, she wanted to start her own business.
Mm-hmm.
So, well, let's try it, you know. So we got a, you know, kind of like incorporate ourselves while we're in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
And we got a couple of items at certain shops in the area. And then when we moved up here, we remember of a particular shop that we visited once before.
Mm-hmm.
And we started there, and we grew. And the opportunity to open this space became available, so we decided to just take a shot at it. We weren't planning on opening the store, but I said, well, you know, this is a good opportunity. Let's go for it. You know, I mean, we're, you know, so the rest is history. So here we are, and it's been a year and a half since we opened the door, and it's been a really amazing opportunity. We met a lot of people. There's a lot of support. It's fantastic, and we met a lot of people with a lot of talented people too, and so they have a place to show their wares and their talents, and we provide that space, and we've been growing ever since.
That's beautiful. Well, so tell us more about that, the space for people to show their wares and their talents. What is that? Is this, would you call that a collective? And kind of explain to people what Ngozi is, because they may not know that the particular things is not things that you're necessarily outsourcing in the sense where you're going overseas or made in China. These are things made by local artists and local artisans, some things actually made
Absolutely.
By yourself.
Absolutely.
So tell us a little bit about what would you call something like this? Is it called a collective? Or
it is actually the name of one of the divisions of Ngozi is this space, which is the Ngozi Design Collective.
Okay.
Our company name is Ngozi Design Group.
Mm.
And so we've always kind of had that idea that it takes a lot of people
That's
together.
Right.
There's a lot of talent out there.
Yeah.
And to have a business in a singular way, I always felt was very narrow.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I like to appreciate, mix, collaborate with other artists and designers.
Mm-hmm.
As Leon said, when this space became available, my first idea was, yes, that we can show off Ngozi brand, and we have all kinds of clothing. We do custom clothing and alterations. We do jewelry, all kinds of beaded jewelry. But I wanted to, when we walked in the door, let's put it this way, when I walked in the door, I was like, how are we going to fill up this place?
Yeah. I was very compelled to stop in front of this beautiful wall. So on this story, I think Ngozi has stories to tell. And this is a beautiful story to tell. So tell us a little bit about the artist. And this is the one you mentioned when we were talking at the desk that actually is art done with crayon?
Yes.
Tell me something. Tell everybody something.
Okay,
about
this art here is done by Demita Hicks, who lives here in Durham.
Okay.
And she does her work on melted crayon. And it's fantastic how the colors pop and the detail and all that. You wouldn't believe that you can do this with anything other than acrylic or oil, but this is actually crayon.
Wow.
Yes, most people that come in, if their crayon box does this. Mine doesn't.
Yeah. So as a prop, we put this box of crayon up there.
You know,
yeah.
I love that. I just got to saw that. I love that. That is so cool.
That's the kind of thing that we like to do with all the different artists to help with the story and to bringing it down, you know, to our level,
yes.
So it's not so heady.
Well,
we ask all of the artists to do a little bio, so that, because people really like to understand the artist
Most
and
definitely.
What motivates them as well.
They get to know the artist too, like you know, like we said before, you know, the artists, we personally know them, and they come in and they're like a family.
Exactly.
So we do all the support for them,
yes.
The marketing and promotions and stuff like that. And We get to know them, and they get to know us.
But she has bags. I wanted, do you actually make this? Is this yours?
These are a combination.
Okay.
And that's one of the other things that we do here at Ngozi. We mix and match the designers and hang stuff together.
Right.
This is actually three or four designers in here.
Uh-huh.
This is from Zimbabwe, these straw bags.
I love these bags.
These are from Tanzania. There's a few in there from Zimbabwe as well.
Yes.
These little bags I've been making probably for about 20 years.
These
I started making them. Little clutch bags.
Yes.
And we started making those for gifts. And people love them. We've been selling them forever.
I love it.
And then we have little tote bags.
Wow. And I love the tote.
Cards in here, leather bags, also from Tanzania.
I love it. Let me check out the tote bag. The tote bag is for the farmer's market.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, ladies.
Yeah,
I'm just
going to
give
you
an idea. Show us how it works, y'all.
Okay, now you're all going to challenge me, are you? So these you just fold up.
Wow.
Kind of
and
like
snap.
That. Stick
I see
the thing
that
in there
snap.
And snap it and
there you
close
go.
It. And,
oh,
and it looks
wow.
Like that. And
it's gorgeous. So
and
listen,
you do
y'all.
It neatly.
So just so you know, that bag is this.
Yes.
So this is what it looks like. Then
carrying
you undo
your
it.
Bag,
carry a little bag.
And you're good to go.
Let me just show you because this is gorgeous. I might have to pick up one before I leave. So this one here. Farmer's Market, I'm just saying, like,
there
you want to be
yes.
Afrocentric, then you need to, $20, it's okay to ask for prices. So I want you to know what I love about the shop, too, is it's something for everyone because there's so much affordability in here. It's like she said, if you want to spend $2,000, you can do that here. It's well worth it. If you want something beautiful that will last you forever for $20, it's here as well. So
and everything is guaranteed because it's handmade. You know, there may be flaws in it, something might break. We try to use top-notch materials, but we understand that things do break.
Mm-hmm.
They're not machine-made, they're not made in a factory, but everything is guaranteed.
Absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much.
We started with 9 friends, and then we've grown to 50 friends.
Wow.
We know every artist and designer that's in here.
Yes.
And we find them by going to festivals. People recommend artists and designers. Some just come in walking off the street. How do I get in?
Mm-hmm.
Leon and I jury everyone that comes into this space, and we look for, obviously, quality first,
mm-hmm.
But creativity
yeah.
and color and
yeah.
something that we think we can sell and that our customers and clients would appreciate.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a joy for us
yeah.
as much as it is for our customers because we never know what's going to come through the door.
Exactly.
An artist will come in, or even an artist that's been here for a while will come in with a new idea, something
mm-hmm.
they made, and it's like, wow, that's really cool. I think we can sell it. Being in production all of my life in the fashion industry and sourcing, I had a lot of hands-on experience with merchandising and marketing
mm-hmm.
and engineering and design and sales.
Mm-hmm.
Because production is really the backbone
mm-hmm.
of the industry. So we are able to kind of merchandise things around, and we get a lot of good feedback also from the designers and from our customers.
Well, wait, speaking of good feedback, let me just say, okay, I want to let my folks to know, they have been here for a year and a half, as they said,
mm-hmm.
and in a year and a half, they already won the Best of Durham 2017. I want them to talk a little bit about that. Like, what is that, first of all? And how do you get it? Like, do you have to get voted to have this? And what is it based on? Is there categories? Like, first of all, congratulations on your Best of Durham 2017. I see the sticker in the window. I just want you to know the sticker is on everything. It is on the pamphlet.
Yeah, I wasted no time in that.
I wasted no time.
That's a test.
I see these posts though, y'all. New York, New Jersey all the way. And yeah, so it's a beautiful, your business card is absolutely wonderful. So please, y'all, tell us about this Best of Durham 2017. What does it mean?
We were actually surprised.
Oh.
We knew about Durham Magazine and this annual contest. We
okay.
voted in it in previous years.
Oh.
It does have categories as restaurants, boutiques,
okay.
gift shops, hair salons, everything, name it. And there's a Best of Durham. And so we were surprised when we were nominated.
Mm-hmm.
And that was back, I think, in the early part of the year.
Mm-hmm.
And you are voted by customers, clients, friends,
okay.
and whoever. And we were happy to be, you know, nominated.
Mm-hmm.
And we kind of forgot about it.
Mm-hmm.
So I was working at home one afternoon about 2 months ago because they said that the winners would be announced in June or July, I think June.
Mm-hmm.
And I get a phone call from Durham Magazine. And I won't say the person's name, but she said, well, is this Andrea Carter from Cozy Design? So I said, yes, it is. And I'm thinking in the back of my head, oh my goodness, what did I do? And she said, well, I have the unfortunate job of telling you. And I don't even know if I heard anything after that. But after that came that you're a winner of Best of Duro.
Wow.
In the boutique category.
Wow.
So I was, after I finished screaming and jumping up and down and asking her if it was real, she told me I had to keep it a secret for 2 months. So I then said I didn't think that was going to happen.
Yeah, that was,
thank you.
We did our best.
Yes.
But we were just very happy and, you know, praise God from whom all blessings flow.
Yes.
Really appreciate the support from the community, the support from folks that walk by, that come to Durham from out of town. We try to represent our artists and designers the best we can.
Yeah. So we're going to go, because I mean, like, the elephant in the room. Y'all probably thinking, they sell sewing machines, too?
No,
actually,
handmade,
exactly. Actually, they don't sell sewing machines. They actually do and teach sewing classes. And so I want to tell us about this. Are you one of the instructors?
Yes.
And then, so there's instructors?
Yes.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about that.
We call ourselves sewists, and, mm-hmm. and there are so many people that come in and ask us to teach them how to sew.
Yeah.
So for adults, we have five, there are five of us that teach.
Mm-hmm.
I'm usually the backup teacher because we're running the store.
Right.
But we do private classes. They are $25 an hour.
Mm-hmm.
And then we
That's
will
perfect.
Teach either from A to Z,
yes.
or we'll teach projects. If you have
mm-hmm.
a project that you need to do, you know, then I can, we'll just help you put on sleeves or put in pockets in or do some alterations. But one thing I did notice about teaching people how to sew
mm-hmm.
was that you're not just teaching people how to sew. You really have to start teaching people how to use a machine.
That's true.
Because sewing is really very easy. It's
Got
putting
you.
Two pieces together
Got
and building you. One upon another. But the technique of sewing is really very interesting.
I
we have
it.
A ball.
That's so wonderful. And is there an age range or group? Or is
we try to stay, you know, 18 and up.
Okay,
we're
good.
Thinking about doing children's classes, young adult classes, young teen classes. But it's a whole different set of safety rules
Got
and
you.
Instructions.
Okay.
So we want to think about what we're doing.
That's wonderful. And men, women, because my husband
men,
wants to join.
Okay. Oh, yeah, we've had everybody.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. It's beautiful.
Absolutely.
I'm loving it.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to go here. So I just want to tell you that they do have a dressing room. And I mean, I think that's important because ladies definitely want to see what they're buying, wear it before they buy or buy it before they wear it. So they want to see what it looks like. So I just wanted to show you that everything is just really so beautifully placed. Again, my beautiful orange wall. And so in here is
entertainment.
Hospitality. If you're feeling that. And I love it. They are very
Absolutely.
Hospitable. And this is just an example. I just really wanted to show you. This is an example of the kind of place you're coming into. They just said it's about family and like being in their living room, more than just a business. It really is a home. And I really appreciate that.
We gave out about a dozen bottles of water today
because
it's so hot outside.
Wow.
We have a refrigerator in the bathroom storage.
Wow.
So if people want some coffee, they just want to hang out, or if it's really hot,
that's beautiful.
You know, we offer them ginger tea, sorrel, and water.
That's cool.
So these are some amazing hats.
Yes.
This is Angela Frazier. And all of these hats are made by hand. She does have an online presence as well.
Sister.
She's only been here for about a month. Some of these hats are reversible. She does the fedoras, she does Applejacks, all of the classic old school styles that we have come to know and love. And we're just really wishing her well. And like I said, she's a new vendor for us, and we are promoting her, and people are loving her hats.
I love her hats. I love it.
Yes.
Beautiful. Thank you so much.
The artist is Greg Page, and this was a commission project because he used to sit outside on the sidewalk. Leon actually met him, and he would do portraits outside.
Mm-hmm.
And we always looked at him and said, well, you really capture the spirit of whoever he happened to be drawing at
Absolutely.
The time. So we asked him, because as much as we do love, you know, Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, and you know, more of the recognizable, readily recognizable.
Right.
I noticed that when we had Tupac Shakur up here, we had Erykah Badu, we had a few LeBron James.
Yes.
Everybody that walked in here knew who they were.
That's right.
And so we commissioned him to do some iconic figures that may not be so popular.
Right.
And I would say most of the folks that come in here maybe know three or four.
Yeah, I agree.
We wanted to think about doing this on an ongoing basis and having this tour around to some of the academies and schools and libraries and community centers so that not just children but also adults begin to see these pictures and know who these people are, what they've brought to the planet, not just to the Black community. Dr. Katherine Johnson, everyone knows now as the mathematician in the recent movie
that came out.
Dr. Barber, Katherine Dunham, Farrakhan, Minister Farrakhan, Dorothy Height, Paul Robeson. I don't think anybody knew, unless they were over 45, 50, never heard of Paul Robeson. So we thought that these, I insisted we have six and six,
yes,
men and women,
yes,
to start.
Of course.
And then when I started doing some research about others that we might want to include in this project, thousands of images going way back into ancient Africa.
Awesome.
So,
beautiful.
At some point we will continue on with this project.
I love it. Thank you so much. I love that. So, like you said, history. Making it modern for all of us, our youngsters and our oldsters. So, tell me this here. I bought one of these. I love it. Sure did. It was this one right here.
Yep.
I bought this.
This is actually from Tanzania, but most of the pieces on this rack, this is our cultural consignment shop.
Oh,
and what that means is that I love to go to thrift shops.
Right.
Being in New York, we stayed in thrift shops.
Exactly.
But when I come to thrift shops now, it just looks like somebody bought something at Macy's and wore it one year too long and then left it to try to sell.
Mm-hmm.
So I asked all of my friends and everybody on our database, which is I think over 3,000 at this point, to bring in some of their globally designed pieces. And we've got lots of African outfits that are gently used, but they go down each month in price, about 5%. And lots of my friends started bringing their clothes in to sell. So you can bring clothing in to sell. And then we have, I bought quite a number of outfits from this rack. And this one rack, this one little rack, has sold over 200 garments.
Oh my goodness, it might be 200 garments. Now what size is this one here?
This one looks like a medium.
Medium.
Let me check that out.
Come on,
man.
So I'm just pulling along. I was trying to get it, it just happened. But thank you so much, and I love this old-fashioned.
This is my mother's sewing machine.
Oh my God,
it still works.
Like real. What?
Yeah, the first 6 months that we were open, it was in the window, and my mom taught me how to sew. So yeah, it's always
beautiful.
There. Okay,
wonderful.
Y'all are so, like, really
have
me crying up in here?
Yes, that is just a little story time.
Yeah,
you know, like, it's real. Okay.
Yes, so that is her machine. Like, it does still work.
Of course.
This is a new vendor for us as well. This is a young lady who walked in and used to have a retail shop.
Okay.
I think it was in Chicago or somewhere. All these pieces are from Zimbabwe, from her travels. And so she had some inventory left over and asked us if we would sell it for her.
And tell me what this is.
These are placemats. They're all hand painted. Everything in here is made by hand. There are little brooms and mortar and pestle, copper pieces.
Afrocentric home decor.
Mm-hmm.
And
home
also
decor.
I mean, you know what? So this is the napkins, is there?
The napkins and the placemats.
I love the complete set. I just think that's just a beautiful touch. It's beautiful. Lovely. And so are these
Yes, these are brooms and mortar and pestle. We just sold one of those as a wedding gift someone brought in.
Lovely.
So those are really beautiful. You have your fresh herbs and just mash them up.
Oh, I love them. We have one of these, but we don't have an Afrocentric one. That's why it's
carved.
And how much is something like this?
I think these, I have to look.
I know, I'm telling y'all, I'm put on the spot. This is not supposed to be for that. I'm trying to show
it's
them.
Okay, hey, whatever.
Yes,
you have three different sizes. They're
35
to 45.
They're
three
beautiful.
Different sizes.
So I just want you to know, the very affordable and excellent and beautiful.
Yes.
Now you have to tell me about the brooms.
Those are brooms. We have two different sizes, but it is only one price. And she's really looking
gorgeous.
to
The brooms are $18.
This is stunning. $18. Mm-hmm. You could actually hang it on the wall. Mm-hmm. You could actually use it. You could put it in a corner. You could put it over a door. I mean, the beautiful things that you could do with something so beautiful. It is very reminiscent of Africa and how they sweep there.
Well, this is one of our favorite projects.
Okay.
It's called Swap to Feed.
Swap to Feed.
So you're going to make me cry again.
Uh-huh.
But this was actually an idea that Nina Freelon, who was a good friend of mine, gave to me. We were trying to figure out what are we going to do with pieces that don't sell or out of season or bad size or there might be a damage.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, maybe I'll just give them away, kind of out of laziness. Mm-hmm. And she was like, girl, you don't give none away for free.
Get some
cans of food for it.
That's right.
And so I thought that was a brilliant idea.
Yes.
And this little rack here, I think we just did our third or fourth month of bringing boxes of food. People bring either two non-perishable items or $10, and then we'll buy the food for anything on that rack, and then you can take it for free.
That's
wonderful. So
that's
anything
amazing.
That's around the store, we call it Swap to Feed, and we are always putting new pieces on there.
Wow.
People come in. One girl skipped out of here. She brought in like 14 cans of beans.
Yes.
And she got quite a number of pieces.
We fed some families, we heard.
Yes.
Wow, that's beautiful. See, I did not know this. I'm learning so much. This is very touching.
Okay. From South Africa.
South Africa.
Yes, it's an Ndebele tribe in South Africa.
And
one of our very good friends, Angela, who had absolutely had a trunk show this weekend.
Oh.
She met these ladies, and
wow.
She's working with them very closely to design beaded pieces.
Wow. Absolutely stunning. Color.
Beautiful.
I mean, this is amazing. Like somebody did this by hand.
By hand.
Amazing.
Yes.
Just had
and she is one of our top sellers. In
wow.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Look
pieces.
At this. So, yes.
This is, again, one of our best-selling designers. Her name is Lillian Danielli. She's actually at the Essence Festival this weekend.
Oh, go ahead.
She has a store down in Goldsboro, and she has blessed us with her collection for summer 2017.
So
all of these pieces are made in Tanzania.
Okay.
And most importantly, I know she would kill me if I didn't say this, that she is supporting an orphanage in Tanzania. So some of the proceeds from her pieces go to support that orphanage in Tanzania.
I got it. So I'm just pulling out the extra.
So she has beautiful pieces.
Yeah.
Really, really beautiful pieces. The fabric quality is some of the best that I've seen.
Oh my gosh, this is gorgeous. Wait, do I have a
design?
Is that skirt?
You
have
the strapless, I think you bought.
Oh, well, the strapless, that's her.
Yeah,
yes, the blue strapless.
Yes, the longer pieces are hanging behind you.
Okay, good. I love her. I love her design.
Yes.
So
she has a great eye for color, for pattern, for print.
Oh, my. And
so
sizes?
And just putting those together. Sizes are small to 3X.
That's wonderful. That's good to know. I know y'all wanted to know that. And so I'm just
so she has short skirts, long skirts, high lows.
Beautiful.
Gowns, everyday work pieces. Blouses. She really is clever. She's really doing her homework.
Yeah.
You know,
talk about mixing the modern
and bringing contemporary styles.
Contemporary styles all the way.
Yeah.
We wear that with a pencil skirt.
We joke with her because you can put a magic belt on any of these pieces and it's beautiful.
That's right.
This piece here is actually, it's called like a pyramid dress.
A pyramid dress.
You know, you really can throw a magic belt on
sure
it.
Sure, and everybody's going good
to go.
It's a really good for everyone. I
it
love
really
it.
Is.
Thank you so much. Let's talk about the art here.
Okay, this is a fairly new artist with us. Her name is Kuti
Desai.
And I believe she lives here in Durham.
Okay.
And how she does this art here, she actually does the drawing on an iPad.
Oh, wow.
Does the drawing on an iPad and colors it on the iPad. And then she has it printed out on canvas.
Get out of here. I just love the process.
Yes.
So that's what you said. Unique, different, creative.
And that's what we like. When people come in, it's like, I drew it. I'm like,
Wow.
You know, but if they really have a story.
Oh, my God.
You know, it's awesome.
That's very fascinating. Mm-hmm. I thank you for that very...
That piece over there, she is a costume designer, Pamela Bond.
Oh,
she is also one of our artists.
Okay, good.
And she does fiber art.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, fiber art. So what does that mean, fiber?
She scraps remnants of fabrics,
okay, really?
And then she places them around.
So it's kind of like modern-day quilting almost in a way.
Kind
of like,
yeah.
Wow. That is so cool. Okay, so, didn't know that, and thank you so much. Mm-hmm. Yes, look at the detailing. I mean, I see something here.
Yes, what we do is we have a number of artists and designers that are also learning interns. Mm-hmm. We have a full-time intern, Rasul.
Yes, Rasul.
And then we also had a couple of other students who were learning to sew or, you know, doing some pieces here. So we give them work to do, and then
that
they work on
so
commission.
Cool. I love
so,
that idea. That's
these
a
some
wonderful
of the pieces.
Thing.
These are for some of the kids. We have the alphabet, so we have a couple of alphabet pillows left.
This is so wonderfully, even the basket that's holding the pillows is the ball. Now, books too.
We have books.
Just so they know, because tell us about
one
it.
Of the, well, we kind of have two mantras. One is that we try to enhance your swagger. We make the assumption, obviously, that you already have some swagger,
that's
which
right.
is enhanced.
Right.
And the other thing is that we believe art is in everything.
Yes.
So
is.
Whether it's
truly.
Books or whether it's CDs, music,
yes.
We have documentaries, we've
yes.
had book release parties here, mm-hmm. And these authors are, and poets are just amazing.
Yes,
so.
Andrew, you're so right, and this is what I talk about a lot on my channel, about art really is in everything,
it
whether
is.
It's a placemat, mm-hmm. a pillowcase,
the
like you said, a book,
is just endless.
It really is, so that's beautiful, and I'm glad you pointed that out. Thank you for that, and now is this another designer?
This is Nishona. These pieces are
okay.
just hanging a little bit longer.
Okay, sorry, because you said these are the longer pieces.
Yes.
And
so
this,
y'all
can't see my dress.
That's the one
that I know it is.
I can't see that dress.
I got to see that dress.
Can't see that dress.
Can't see that dress. Can't see that one.
That one's coming up.
All around.
That one's coming up.
Yes, but this is a beautiful collection. I did buy that dress in here, and you will see it on me, and
yes.
you'll know where I got it from. You do see it. Let's talk about these beautiful t-shirts.
This is another collaboration. They're all t-shirts and little crop tops.
And crop tops.
Yes, these are t-shirts that are hand-painted by Oladele. And he is our Nigerian batik artist, but he also does hand-painting.
Wow.
This is Jean Royster Hills.
Wow.
And these are, this is a technique called shibori, which is kind of like tie-dyeing.
Mm-hmm.
So she takes a plain fabric, she tie-dyes it, or shibori.
Wow.
And then she also hand stamps and hand paints them.
Love it.
And then she makes the garment.
Wow. Love it, love it,
so
love it.
For those of you who may not understand why some of the pricing and some pieces that you
yes.
see that are handmade, a lot of work goes into a lot of work.
That's very much, this is wearable art, basically.
Yeah. And then we also have some graphic design.
Oh.
So these are educators.
Oh, I love that.
So Rasul's sister actually does those t-shirts.
Oh,
she is
sister.
Doing her master's, I believe, in education.
I did not know
And so
that.
She also wants to share her perspective on some of the icons that we
and
have
love,
here.
And my granny,
day.
Too.
And my granny, too.
That
because all of these were somebody's granny.
That's right. Come on now. So I love it, love it, love it. And then I'm looking at these beautiful colors already. This
yes.
already is just, what was this designer
now
here?
This designer, I have to look. This is Anita
okay.
McCoy. And
okay.
these pieces she bought in. And
oh,
they're brand new.
Gorgeous.
They are also from Zimbabwe, from the store that she okay. had. So we saw her home accessory pieces in the back, and she also bought some clothing.
Oh, come on.
And so most of these pieces that are here because they hang a little bit longer.
Uh-huh.
So
okay.
We hung them here because these are our highest bars.
Right.
That Leon actually made this cabinet.
Oh, what?
Let me tell you about the cabinets here. All the cabinetry, all the cabinetry is from a place here in Durham called Trosa, and it supports, I guess, men and women who have gotten beyond their drug and alcohol addiction.
Right.
Okay.
And so all of these pieces are from a thrift shop.
Okay.
I told y'all that we love the thrift shop.
Yes.
This was a very close piece, and then one of our carpenter friends said to open it up, put the bars in here, and he helped Leon figure out how to make it so that we could use it as a shop.
It's so fun.
I think this piece was $40.
Wow, wonderful. So this particular one, yes, definitely
want to
see the books and
mm-hmm.
CDs. So I'm going to just a second. What about this beautiful
This artist
piece?
Is uh-huh. a crochet designer, and so her collection is here.
Okay.
And this is a individual piece. So these are all of her pieces.
Oh, let me pull something out so the ladies can see it. No, this is gorgeous.
Yes.
Look at this piece.
And
this is stunning.
It feels great. It's 100% cotton.
Wow, this is a beautiful piece. This is very lovely. And so all of these are just...
And these, yeah, these are... She's just
pieces.
Getting started.
Gorgeous.
We sold a number of
her
pieces.
Look at that, y'all. This is one
very
piece.
Creative.
Is that? That's lovely. Wow, I love it. And let me just show them. Oh, this piece is so lovely as well.
Yes, we had this piece in the window, and people were like, do you wear something under?
Right, that was going to be my question.
Yes.
My question was going to be, do you wear something
yes,
underneath?
Yes,
of course.
Most young ladies would
probably yeah,
would
yeah,
wear
exactly.
Underneath it.
Definitely. Let's talk artwork up here.
So there you go.
Okay, there's another artist who's local here in Durham, the Delvecchio.
Delvecchio.
Delvecchio Faison. Mm-hmm. And these are original acrylic on canvas. And you can see his main theme is jazz.
I love jazz.
And I believe he is an art teacher.
Wow.
Yes, that's right. He is an art teacher.
Is this new or has this been here for?
He's been here for about 2 or 3 months.
2 or 3 months. Okay.
These pieces are sculptured by Najib
yes.
Asani. He had his book release party here a few weeks
that's
ago.
Right.
And these are his some of his characters from his book that has recently been released, Legends
mm-hmm.
of O'Neill.
Nice.
He is currently working on a GoFundMe. Program
okay.
so that he can complete his animated trailer and film.
Wow.
He also has a coloring book, and I'm waiting for my copy
that's
as
right.
we speak.
That's right.
And he's done these two pieces up here, too.
Yes.
So these are his
as these
yes.
are his pieces.
Oh, wow.
He has actually created these this entire world, these characters.
Right, exactly. Yeah, I remember
yes.
this before the table before. This
and
is
a very successful book release. Sold out.
So glad to hear so it. Very love that. Section, because that don't get a lot of love. Come over here. Come over here, man.
We don't have much of a men's department,
but
we're working on it.
Yeah.
We have some shirts here. Most of these are from Tanzania.
Most
of
them
are
from Tanzania. Some
of them about this stood out to me, like gorgeous.
This one is from
Ghana.
Mm-hmm. I love it. I wanted to show them quite a few.
And then we have some that have been handmade here by a Tanzanian artist.
Okay.
And we also have some local.
Oh, my gosh. This
mm-hmm.
is all gorgeous.
That one is also from Tanzania. And
okay.
all of that hand stitching was...
Hand stitching. Mm-hmm. Just checking it out, y'all.
Something that sells very well.
Lovely.
Beautiful prints.
Love that. Love that. And I know Leon will be sporting some of these wonderful
yes.
shirts.
Well,
I've
asked the... designer, if you can get me a large, this is a little too big for me.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm patiently waiting.
I'm so glad. Well, I remember when we went out the night to see the African
mm-hmm.
group
mm-hmm.
And the African artists, and we all took that picture.
Mm-hmm.
They were complimenting us on our whole, get up.
The whole
vibe. I just want to say they felt it.
We also make pants.
Oh, wow. Lovely. Mm-hmm. Lovely.
The shorts here.
I love that. And this is all the same designer?
This
no,
is
this
a designer
is
in New York.
Yeah.
This is y'all.
So it's our brand.
Oh, this
the designer
brand.
In New York
these.
Has made the pants for us.
Go ahead, Dad.
Yes.
So this is his
I might
brand.
Buy these. These
I'm
me.
Telling you. Yeah, Leon. Definitely,
every,
you should take
and
them.
And as you can see, we work
design.
With all fabrics. So we have linens.
Love it. Love the linen.
We have our linen, yeah.
And then this is also a man's
yes.
menswear as
and
well.
This is Zimbabwe, Nigeria, New York,
wow,
and Durham.
There you go.
All in one outfit.
Right, exactly.
Now we're talking cosmetics
yes, and then
or
we have
health?
Some personal care items
okay.
that I recommend
okay,
specifically.
Great. Love this. This is
yeah, this is part of Soulful Creations, who is a Durham local.
Okay.
And she makes the shea butters and she
okay.
makes a lot of the balms, the hairsprays.
Right, for locks and twists and braids.
All kinds
and
of good stuff.
Yes, okay,
smells
good.
Great.
So a woman,
and she has
and
this.
She makes this for
yeah,
men. Okay,
and so
good.
These fragrances are, kind of for men, but
yeah.
we also have some fragrances for women.
Oh, yeah, we're getting over there. Because this is my girl.
So there we go,
right
Ooh Man.
She makes the Ooh
Man
as well.
For, yes, and this is Ravani Haynes. She does
yeah.
the soaps. And the candles.
Oh, we're
going to
talk
candles.
About her because I buy her candles all the time.
Yes.
And lovely African
And we have African ties.
Ties. So beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
And then we have some kufis. Gotta have kufis.
Exactly. Oh, I love them. Beautiful.
Yes,
actually.
And those are embroidered.
They can
I
see it in
they
there.
They are from, not sure where they are from.
That's beautiful. Yeah, this is very affordable.
But I'm thinking it's either Nigeria.
Gorgeous.
Or
lovely. And this
okay.
this is new.
And then this is all new.
Okay.
Again, a collection of different artists. Lovely. These are coasters that we had around Father's Day.
Oh, nice.
And so this is the, again, we'll get to this artist,
love
but he
it.
Does embroidery on our showcase.
Oh,
which is a Nigerian
dressy fabric that he's using.
I love that. That is so, I love the feel. If y'all could feel this, the feel is so awesome. And you know what? I see it looks,
it keeps it from
exactly moving. That is so cool.
There you
go.
You can give that to your awesome dad.
I love it.
Great.
Love
these are hand etched, deeply rooted.
How cool is that?
Drinking glasses.
Deeply rooted drinking glasses.
I think I'm going to have to buy them.
Yeah, definitely. That is so fly. I love that very much. And is this some more
And
coasters?
Those are more, yes, for our men.
I love it. Thank you, Dad. This is
great. We just didn't want to take them down after Father's Day was over because, you know, Father's Day is 365.
It's got to be. But, talk a little bit about
and
the
then
masks.
These masks are from an estate sale.
Oh, really?
A friend of ours.
Can I pick one up and just show
Absolutely.
Them?
We've already purchased a few pieces from the table.
See, look at the beauty of
that. She downsized from a 7-bedroom house, moved down here to a smaller place, and she has all of these things that she purchased over the years from her travels and from online.
Wow.
And so she's sharing them with this community so that, again, they're affordable. I don't think there's anything there that's over $200.
No, you're right. This beautiful one is $75.
So, yeah,
oh, that's gorgeous.
Very
put
well
that
priced.
Yeah, connect. This is, I would buy this one right here.
I know, right?
This is gorgeous.
And they're all decorative masks.
Wow. Cameroon! This is my people, y'all.
Cameroon.
This is the people when I did my DNA and traced it back to Cameroon.
Really, Cameroon.
That's why.
There you go.
Oh, my goodness.
So there you go. Sold.
Right, so I'm telling you. Wow. Cameroon, like, oh,
it's
my
beautiful.
Goodness. Wow, like, okay, I need to just sit here and look at this. I'm really taken. It's not my tribe, but I'll forgive y'all for that. I love that. Camera.
Beautiful.
Okay, thank you. Let me just see this one other piece here. I think they would love to see it. Mm-hmm. Ooh, we're going to have people knocking down the door in a minute to come on.
Yes.
Okay, and this is another
We already
one.
Have. We've had people
it's
coming
gorgeous.
In buying this already. We've
I'm
only
so
had
glad.
A few weeks.
I'm so glad. I love it. I think it's really beautiful. Thank you, ma'am, for showing us. Gorgeous. And then this is fairly new.
This is, yes. Well, this is actually a second collection.
Okay.
This artist has been here for probably about 8 months.
Okay.
She had 4 wall hangings before. And
beautiful.
I don't think she really expected someone to come in and bought all 4 of them.
Wow.
And so she got to work and bought 4 more in.
So is it quilts?
But these are all quilted.
Okay.
She comes up with her idea and then she has a story for each one.
Wow, and this one says so
celebrating
freedom. Isn't that
mm-hmm.
lovely? This one is just gorgeous. I love it. Yeah, the Ashanti fertility statue. So for all your ladies that's trying to get pregnant, you might want
to
put that
up
in
up on
strategic
the
place. Exactly. Gorgeous.
And then just we have it. Masks, and then she uses, you know, these different African prints very nicely.
Love it, love it, love it. And so if you will walk, when you come down the street of Main Street, and you pass this wonderful window and display, you will see this her stuff that she's actually displaying, her beautiful collection. And I just want her to show us, because like I'm seeing some things. Well, is this the skirt? Is this by
this? Is an apron skirt.
Okay, this is gorgeous.
This one.
This
one
here.
These are our hardest working
employees.
Yes, they are.
Yeah, they don't take a break. They don't get tired.
They don't eat.
Exactly.
So this
gorgeous.
Is a dress that we made a few years ago, actually, and the customer never wore it because she said that the waistline was a little bit too high. So I guess she didn't want me to feel bad.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, we could have altered it, but she never told me.
No,
so
exactly.
I told her I certainly will sell it and make her a very good customer of ours.
And did you call it an apron dress? Is that the apron?
And this one is an apron
skirt.
And we just sold one of these last night, actually. It was black and white.
That's gorgeous.
But this is a high-low,
so you
would have to wear something under it.
Lovely.
But it just ties at the waist.
It's lovely.
And then it's on in the back.
Lovely.
And it really is beautiful as you're walking down.
Oh, I can see.
She twirled out of here.
Oh, yes. Beautiful. Now, tell us about
this. And then
this
is an African designer, South African designer. This is a hand-painted skirt,
beautiful.
Fully lined. So this trim here is the lining. So it wraps around and lines the whole entire inside of the skirt.
Gorgeous.
And then the outside is, as you can see, it is hand-painted.
Hand-painted.
His name is Muncho.
Yeah.
I believe his first name is Leon.
Yeah.
And he is from South Africa.
Good name.
And then this fabric I just kind of learned about recently. It's called shway shway.
Ah,
and
shway
it's,
shway.
And it's manufactured in South Africa.
Lovely. So now this one, I remember this piece I was looking at, and you didn't have it in small last time.
No, we didn't
you
have
still?
It.
No?
We don't
okay.
Know. Yeah, because they're one of a kind, and I think they were, he just said, we'll take
exactly.
Some and see if they like it.
All right.
Of course we like it.
So, yeah.
So we're trying to get more very soon.
That'd be great. Angela and Leon Carter of Ngozi in Durham, North Carolina. And I just wanted to kind of remind you that this is only part one. We actually have another part that we'll be uploading within not too long, maybe a few days from now. And so I want you to stay tuned for that. I hope you enjoyed it. I want to remind you all that if you do happen to go into Ngozi, whether you're coming from anywhere in the country or the world, and you do visit, please mention my name, Lisa Marie. I think they would be wonderful. They would be wonderfully appreciated to them and me as well. And let them know I sent you. Again, I hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for part two, which will be coming in a few days. And I hope, and again, and also this dress, I'm going to haul this dress, so don't worry about that. All right, love you all with all my heart. This is Lisa Marie Goodson. And again, thank you for being part of the Afrocentric Home and Style Channel. Peace and blessings.